G'day, you dancing legends.
We are really happy to have you here with us today at Cool Cats Dance Studio.
And my name is Sarah, and this is my husband Nathan, and we're going to answer some of your frequently asked questions today, starting with why you need a partner to come to our lessons.
Yeah, okay. So, as principal of the studio, it was a decision I made number of years ago, that partially as a teaching preference, I prefer to work with couples because I feel that I can get more development out of them that way than your traditional round robin, everybody rotate class. Now, that's not true for everyone, but I've certainly found it true for a lot of couples over time. With that, then we have a number of different ways in which that process of working only with couples can actually help facilitate people at different stages of their dance journey. We want everyone to learn how to dance, but there's very few opportunities apart from doing private lessons for those people who just want to dance with somebody consistently rather than changing all the time, so they can focus on whatever it is that they need to focus on in terms of their particular pain points in their dance journey. For some, it may be they're just getting started and they really want to have some consistency in terms of the feedback and the person that they're working with so that it's a stable platform, as it were, to learn on. And for others, there can be a number of different issues why they may not want to dance with somebody else, such as?
I would say if you're not working with a consistent partner, it makes it very hard as a follow to interpret leads when the leads that are being given are constantly by a new person, which by nature makes them a little bit different, maybe because the lead's a bit taller than you, or maybe you're used to leading someone who's short as opposed to tall. So having that consistency there with partner allows you to be that bit more comfortable with them as well.
Yeah.
And I would go on and ask you, in your opinion, what are some of the benefits of working with a stable partner or even just the same person?
Look, there are so many benefits of, let's say, not needing to change partners. And that being said, we welcome people coming with their own small group if they want to change between themselves and they're happy doing that, particularly families. If they want to come along as their own small group and mom and dad are dancing with, daughter and son, that's great. Mm-hmm. I've had that before. And it's one of those things that this sort of format allows for, whereas it wouldn't be possible otherwise. So that benefit, just like in terms of without the teaching, I think it provides a benefit in terms of bonding. I mean, that can be bonding with the friend that you turned up with to dance in class. It can be bonding with your special someone as you've turned up with them. And it can be that bonding with and between your family or your group of friends as you're all sharing the experience together. And that's not to say that you can't get elements of that in a rotational class. I start in a rotational class. I've got lots of second mums out of that second class because I was dancing with my mum at the time. But of course, I really love dancing with my mum and I still dance with my mum to this day. And certainly for some of those family groups or friend groups that we've had, the fact that they get to work with their own small group and focus on where they're at, whether it's for a wedding party, we've had wedding parties come through, whether it's because they just, want to take it on as something that they're doing together as a group, or, it could just be, as I was saying before, it's that special someone, which kind of brings us into the flip side of when you're in a rotational class, there may be a lot of non-special someones in that class that you'd actually really rather not be dancing with, either because you struggle with their leading or their following. And I will note that rotational classes do have a benefit for follows a lot of the time in terms of the variation that Sarah was talking about. Is once you pass that initial stage and you get to understand where things are going, understanding variation in how the same figure, the same motions can be led by different leads is actually valuable to you in terms of being able to dance with different people. But you have to contrast that then with, well, okay, what about that person that you may really not want to dance with? I've, over the years, having run rotational classes before, had to kick out, particularly guys, that a lot of the women weren't comfortable with. But I've also had, over time, some of the gents turn around at me and say, look, not really keen to be dancing with this person. Is there any way that we can avoid this? So, love the social aspect of a rotational class, but we find that we get really good social interaction between our students. Everyone's at a different stage on their dance journey, but because they're working just with the partner that they came with, they can really take it at their own pace and develop as they're comfortable and then feel comfortable with everyone else in the class.
Yeah, and it'd be great if you could talk into why it benefits teaching by the couple in terms of being able to personalize the feedback and the tuition we're able to give people, which I think is a huge benefit to why you would bring a partner to class with you.
Yeah, well, I mean, let's face it, most people can't afford to be doing private lessons every week. It's great when you can, and that's nice, but most of us can't. Now, our classes are all teaching the same content to everyone in the class, but because we have a real focus on teaching outcomes, we don't let that class size ever get too big. And that way we're able to spend that one-on-one time. And one of the key parts that I like to see out of class is I ask my students, okay, what have you picked up on? Where are your trouble points? And particularly we can find that when there's maybe some, let's say, passionate conversation between dance partners, I'm able to come in objectively and talk through it, which I won't say is impossible in a rotational class, but it's a lot more difficult, particularly as one person's moving through to the next. I've particularly dealt with a number of confused leads over the years in rotational classes because they're getting feedback from so many different women on, you should do it this way, you should do it that way. And of course they come to me as the teacher, like, well, how should I actually be doing it?
Yeah, and often that feedback that the lead is given between women, and I've seen this firsthand in the very limited times where I've been to rotational classes, and the lead is told something completely opposing to what the last person told them before they moved on. So as the lead, it's very confusing if one person's saying, oh, you're too rough, and the next person says, oh, you're too soft. So that's another benefit of coming with a partner and why we teach to that.
Yeah, and also part of that is every student's different. I can teach the base content to everyone, the same figures, the same technique that I might want everyone to show, but not everyone picks up on the same things. For some people, I might say it just as is in class and it drops into place in a moment. But for somebody else, I might get the questions about, well, what do you mean, or what's this in relation to? And then I can try other ways of explaining the same thing differently for them. It's not any really different content, or it's not actually dealing with any particular pain point that they have. But, you know, as a common example, guys will often tend to like to work with numbers. I break it down into this happens on this beat, this happens on this beat. Women more frequently can be more associated with words, or indeed reflective against what the lead's doing. It's like, when he's here, this is when, you know, you want to be thinking or doing this. So you can't go and just treat everyone the same and expect that everyone's going to pick up on what you're teaching the same way. And that ability to adjust, particular to the individual and then to each couple, because each couple is a different dynamic. That's a real plus for me in teaching by the couple the way that we do.
Definitely. And I think being able to teach an entire class, but then you have some people that have been coming along to lessons for quite a while, and we can focus on the higher finesse of the figure and maybe smaller points such as handholds or body pressure, which we wouldn't necessarily be trying to overwhelm a beginner or someone that has just learnt to dance with those finer points. So that's how we can offer different levels of intuition in the one class as well, which is quite good.
Yeah, and one other benefit that I would say is, as a former competition dancer and judge for many years, I'd love to encourage everyone, we'll do a different video as to why I encourage everyone to perform or compete, but that's, if you want to excel in your dance and you want to like delve into that more, if you don't have that consistent dance partner, it's, I would say, next to impossible at that point. I have done it previously, in terms of going to demonstrations and performing in a demonstration with someone who was not my regular dance partner, but they were part of my training competition team. I knew them quite well and were quite really able to pick up the content together and the connection to make it work. But with that exception aside, I would say it being quite difficult to really get to those areas of polishing up your dance without that person to be there with you. And so you're working on it together as a team. And this all comes back to the end of the day. We teach partner dance styles. It's a great thing to learn to dance, and I've done my share of lessons where I've been, you know, without a dance partner. I do have the good fortune though of being a lead, and there tends to be a whole lot more ladies looking for a guy to dance with than there are the other way around. So even with that, I would take having a dance partner, a consistent partner to work with all the time, because then I can just, you know, say, hey, look, this one wasn't quite working right, or this bit over here, and then smooth it out and make it really shine, because that's the sort of way that I'm inclined. I like my dancing to, you know, not just look good, I like it to feel good. I like it to feel like it's flowing the way that it should. And there is no substitute for developing a connection with a dance partner where it's almost like you just come into sync with each other. And then the content, once you've reached that point, starts to feel easy because you're not trying anymore to figure out the other person.
Mm.